Okay, it's time. Too bad for the one not on time. So I'm gonna have I hope an interactive session with you, and so if you have questions, we can discuss them. And I'm gonna I don't have any PowerPoint, so it's easy for me to prepare, right? I just take the demo website that we have online, and so I'm gonna show you hands-on what you can do with CKShop and answer you live to see how to do some of the things I'm talking about. So this website is the one we have online. It's a 2.5 website, Joomla 2.5 website, so it's an old one. We are actually currently doing a new one on Joomla 3. So it's going to be great with the responsive and all that, but for now it's only on 2.5. But rest assured that CKShop works fine on Joomla 3 point whatever. So it's just that we don't have it yet ready, so I'm still doing the presentation on Joomla 2.5. What else? So I'm going to present me first, myself first. So I'm Nicolas Claverie. I'm the founder of CKShop, actually Hikari Software, the company who created CKShop and other extensions around CKShop like Hika Market and Hika Serial. I will only talk about CKShop here, but if you have questions about the other extensions that we published or any other questions, we can talk about that later on. No problem, no problem. Okay. So, first, who is familiar with CKShop here? Two, three? Okay, great. So, I'm gonna present how it works. So, all the ones who know might be a bit bored, but the other ones they will have a great time. I hope. I'll try at least. So. Did someone already did an e-commerce website, a shop online? Yeah? A few? Great. Great. So I hope that you know what's an e-commerce website. It's to sell your products online. So we developed an extension to do that, develop a shop online so that you can sell your products with payment processors, shipping rates calculations, checkout, cart, anything that you need to do an online website like maybe Amazon, or maybe not that complex, but something like that. And so I'm going to show you first how CKShop works, so how you can set it up, get started with it, add maybe products, how the checkout works, and then maybe delve into what you need to know to do a proper e-commerce website, handle responsive design, handle the SEO. SEO is a big part of an e-commerce website in order to have no problem. Hi. It's great, it was the introduction while we were waiting for all the people coming in. So yeah, I'm gonna start now that the room is almost full. So, where is the mouse? Oh, okay. So first I'm gonna present. So when you install CKShop on a website, you'll have you can do it like any extension. You go to the Joomla installer, you upload the package via the Joomla installer, or you can directly do it on the new tool they have on Joomla 3, where you can search for extensions from the Joomla extension directory, search for CKShop, and then directly click on the button to install it. And then at the end of the install process, which add the files and the database, you get this page, which is the wizard to set up the first piece of your website, of your e-commerce website. So first it's a page where you can select how you want to present your your content, your products, your categories of products. So you can select to have like a menu at the top where you can click on and which will then display the products in the main area of your website. Or you can have the same but for categories, so then it will show the categories in the main area. Or you can have the categories as a module on the side of your website. And when you click on a category, you will then see the products. And so each one you can select or unselect, so you can actually have all of them activated. That's how it is by default, so you can directly see how it looks like when you create a product. You'll directly see it on your front, on the front page, on the front of your website. Then you can select the default display of the product listing. So you have a grid display with several boxes, one per product, or a list, so where you can have a list of products with the HTML UL LE list, or a table with one product per row with the image, name, and price, or add to cart, and that's it. And then you can select enter some information about your shop, so where you are based from. So obviously you will select Poland if you are Polish, right? And the state, I don't know if you have how it works for the states in Poland. So yeah, you have several states. I don't know which one. Let's take this one. And then you can select your currency. So zloty, you will find it somewhere in here. PLN, yeah, this one. Right, thanks. And then you can enter the tax name. So in France, it's VAT, TVA. Yeah, great. And then the rate, so it's probably higher in France than in Poland, but 5%? Oh, yeah. In France, it's 20, so I don't know. 23? Oh, so it's actually lower in France. Oh, interesting.
So you can get more than one, right?
Yeah, so that's the first setup. That in most countries, you only have one rate for to set up, so that's the easy setup. But then, of course, when you are in Europe, you might need to set several tax rates, but that's more complex, and then you need to go to the tax menu to configure them. That's just the first setup to have a something started. Then you can enter the PayPal address if you have a PayPal account because most of the people actually first have a PayPal merchant account and process their payments with PayPal. It's a great payment gateway to start selling your products online. It doesn't require any kind of complex registration, and you can start selling your products in a few minutes with PayPal. So you just enter the email address here for your PayPal account, and then you will have it already set up on your website. So, and then you can select the type of products that you're going to sell. If you sell ship-up products, like books that you are going to send by the mail to your clients, or if you are selling virtual goods like MP3 or videos or stuff like that, or maybe both. So you do what you want, and then you just click on the big button, and it's gonna set up eCashShop automatically for that. So you will just have to create your products, and you will see them on the shop, and you can add to the cart and go to the checkout, and you have a shop in 2 or 3 minutes. You're ready to go, and then you can go in all the options we have and start configuring if you want more customized experience. So not everyone was here at the beginning, but I will repeat, if you have some questions during the presentation, you can ask me related to what we're talking about. So basically, once you set that up, you will have, for example, maybe you will have a product listing menu at the top of your front end. And so you can click on it. And once you set up a product, you will see it automatically display on the page. And you can just click on the product. Then you can add it to the cart. Once it displays, it's a bit slow here, but it will be faster on your website. And just click on add to quote or add to cart, depends what you have. And then it's gonna add it. Oops. It's gonna add it add the product to the cart. You will see refresh here automatically. You will have the pop-up telling you that the product was added, and you can go to the checkout and place the order. You'll have the registration part, like a normal shop. You can log in or register. Then you can select your shipping method, the payment method. So if you just had configured PayPal, you will have just PayPal here. Here, since it's the demo website, we configured a few more. No problem. And then you have the cart. So that's the default checkout, but you can change it. You can have guest checkout. You can change the order of the elements. You can have the checkout in several steps. So each time the guy has to click on next, go to the next page, fill the information, click on next, go to the next page. So you can configure all that. You can also add custom fields, like if you need more information, shipping date, or whatever. So that's for the checkout. Then you have, so basically you start for, usually you start by adding a new product on your website. So let's go back to that. After you fill the wizard, you will go to the product page where you can enter the product name, you can enter the description. Here you have several fields that can be used for the SEO. So these are really important fields. And so meta description and keywords, I'm sure most of you are familiar with it. They allow you to enter meta description and keywords on the page, the product page of your products. So you have the page title as well, the alias. Alias is for the URL. When you are on a product page, you are in the URL, you have the alias of the product. So that's also important to fill it. And the canonical URL is the main URL of your product page. So if you have several menus or modules that are going from where you can access the products on your website, you might have different links to the product page. And if you enter the canonical URL here, it will be the main link. So all the links will go to this link, and you will avoid duplicated content issues that you could have with SEO, with Google, or other search engines. So that's important. We also have options in HikaShop to fill automatically these fields. So I won't go in the configuration of HikaShop because I don't want to scare you too much. There's a whole lot of options to activate or turn off based on what you want to do, including activating the auto-filling of the meta description, the keyword, the page title maybe not, but the alias and the canonical URLs, they can be generated automatically for you. Yeah? So they also have some options to fill to have the meta description themselves based on the URL or all that. That's something that if you activate it on HikaShop and on SH, then they will both try to do it, and the one that do it the later will have the priority. So maybe you don't want to have activated both of them for HikaShop at the same time. But you can have SH, if you need a third-party SEO extensions like SH404, you can install it and HikaShop will work with it, so that's not a problem. It's not a problem. So then you have some information about the products that you want to fill, so mainly the code. Code is sometimes called SKU in the US. In Poland, and I don't know how you call it, in France we call it the code of the product, so SKU, okay, so SKU. And you have the quantity, it's an important field. If you need to handle the stock of your products, you can fill the stock here, and the stock will decrement automatically when someone purchases the products. And so when it reaches zero, you can tell the system to not allow the sale anymore. Or you can leave it unlimited, and then you can buy as many as you want.
Is it possible to connect it to the normal system of the state of the product in your shop?
They won't be happy if you don't use the mic.
Is there possibility to connect it to the stock on your shop? Yeah, like you have a virtual shop and the normal one, and you want to connect it together with the normal system in your shop.
It depends. You can do it, of course, but then if there is no...
Is it possible to connect it with Hikasha?
It depends. It depends how it works. So sometimes you will have to develop a plugin to do the connection. You can do it if you know, if you're a coder or if you hire someone to do it for you. Sometimes these shop systems, they have an export of CSV, and then in HikaShop you can import the CSV automatically to update the stocks. So you can have that. It depends how the software works and if there is already something available for that. Most of the time people will develop a connector. Then it can go both ways dynamically. It's the best method, but then it requires more work, of course.
Okay, thank you.
Then I'll skip some of the fields here. These are quite important, the weight, length, width, height. These are for ship-up goods. So if your product needs shipping, you will want to fill these so that maybe you have shipping methods that require the weight and the dimensions of the product in order to calculate the shipping automatically. So if you add a 2 kilo product and another 5 kilo product, that's 7 kilos in the cart, and it might be more expensive than just 2 kilos to ship. So you can do that with that. Here the access levels are used a lot to be able to sell products to some user groups and not to others. It's used, like, for example, when you are a big company and you sell to retailers and wholesalers at the same time and maybe just normal customers. So with that you can do both B2B and B2C shops in one shop. So that's the left part. The right part is, so you can have, of course, several categories, several layers of categories in HikaShop, and you can add your products in any category. There's no limit on the numbers of levels or all the numbers of products in each category or whatever. We have people with like maybe a million products with 5,000 categories in them. That's already a really big shop, so if you go that far, then it starts to be some issue with the performances if you don't have a strong server, but you can still do it with HikaShop. So you can have several categories. You can have related products that the user will see on the product page. You have options, characteristics. So rather than talking about the interface here, I'm going to show you what it looks like on the front end. So on the front end, when you have characteristics for a product, so for example, this is a mat that we sell on our demo website. So we have it in several colors. So the default one is black, but you can have in gray or in red. And so with the characteristics, you can have different variants of the product based on the color or based on the size or both at the same time. You can have several characteristics, one for the color, one for the size. And so you can have a different price, as you can see. When we change, the price will change. Maybe not for all of them, but for some of them. And the stock will be different, the image will change. Some of them can be bought, some can't. So you can do all that with the characteristic system, that's what we call it. So as you saw on the product page, we also have options. So if you sell, for example, computers, where you have options for the CPU or for the hard drive, you can have a product page for a computer and you can select the different options. Like, for example, do you want a webcam or not? And so if you select a webcam, the price with the options will be recalculated. And you can have different options like that, change the price. And so then when you add it to the cart, it will add all the options together with the product in the cart. Maybe I didn't click on it. Oh yeah, I clicked it. Right. So here you can see the product with all the options in it. It's a bit small, but it depends on the design that you have and the options that you have. There's a lot of options here. So you can do that. You can also have, that's the option area, the characteristics area. You have also prices. So the prices area, that allows you to have different prices for a product. So for example, if you want to have discounts when the For example, if the person buy one product, you sell it at 10 euros or 10 zloty. And if the person buys two, then each one will cost 9 zloty instead of 10 for each one. So you can do that like that. So for example, you set a price of 10 zloty for one. I only have euros, so let's do with euros. Or 9 for two, so each one will cost 9 if we buy at least two of the products. You can do that. You can also have different prices for different currencies. So if you sell in zloty and in euro on your website, which you can do, you can have the price in zloty and the price in euro. So when someone will buy, he can choose the currency of his country, or you can have the currency set automatically with geolocation. So based on the IP of the customer, the default currency will be set automatically, and it will use the price of that currency. You can do that. You can also have access levels for the prices. So for the same product, you can have different prices for different group of users, etc. You can have several images. You can have several files. So the files, when you add a file here, it will be available for download afterwards. So you can have, for example, an MP3 here. So when the product is bought and that the payment has been done, then the files will be available to the user. It will be able to download it. You can set restrictions on the files, like for example, only for the customer can only buy the product for 3 weeks or only two times, for example. And that's basically it for the simple things. Do you have any questions on that part? Maybe, maybe not. Not? Oh, you have, so.
I wonder how, for example, with the computer, you've got related products with a computer. It is like really related products or no related, I don't know, categories or?
So it's products.
Yeah.
Actually, it's a product with a characteristic. So for example, you would have the webcam with three options,
yeah.
And you can add it to the product computer, and then it will display as a drop down for the selection if you want with or without or.
Okay, thank you.
And oh, another thing is you can use the we have an import tool that you can use to import the products. If you have a lot of products, you can import them with a CSV directly on the website. So if you have 2,000 products, you just use the import and it will create all the products for you. Yes? And you can also import from VirtuMart or other extension e-commerce solutions like RedShop or MyJoShop or OpenCart. You can import all the. Yeah, you can import the photos as well. So we have two modes. Either you give the name of the image in the CSV for each product, and when you import the CSV, it will create links. And then when you upload the images in the upload folder of eCashShop via FTP, for example, it will link them automatically together, and it will generate the thumbnails automatically. And you can also have, like you specify a folder of images, you say that you have that product template, and it will generate a product for each image automatically based on the product template and the images of the folder. That's also something you can do. I'm sorry?
How does look this link?
This
image.
I'm sorry?
How does look this image?
Oh. So well, you won't see much when you import, but in the screen. But like for example, here you can add the images area, and you said that this one will have the image image1.png, and this one has image2.png, for example. And when you import, it will link them together in the database. Or you can even specify several files, several images in the CSV. And you upload them in the upload folder of eCashShop. So if you go to let's say the folder of your website, in media, Comica shop, up, upload. So here you have, so that's the thumbnails that are generated, and here are the images of the products, so you can put them here and it will get them with the products automatically when you do the import, the CSV import. That's basically it. So that's for the products, the categories, so your content. The content can be displayed in several ways, as I explained on the wizard. So here you can see some of the examples. So for example, here you will have some products in grids. You can have products in lists. You can have FX on the listings. So the website is a bit slow, so it's going to be hard to follow me. But so that's for the list. This one is for FX. So you can have like slideshows of your products, images, and yeah, different kind of display. Maybe it's going to load. Yeah, here we are. So for example, this one. You can have like one like this, or one which rotates automatically like that, and one like that, for example. You have plenty of options when you edit a listing of products. You will have plenty of options like these to configure how you want the listing to display, with effects, without effects, with two columns, three columns, five columns, how many products on each page of the pagination, extra. You'll have all you need to do the display you want. And if you need to go further than the options, you can override the display and swap the elements with the editor that we have. I'm going to show you rapidly. So for example, here we have a list of views that's going to display soon. So you can edit a view. And so for example, let's take the listing EMJ title. So that's the one for the display of the grid when you have one image, the name of the image, and the add to cart, and that's basically it. And so you will have, like here you can edit the code. And so that's not a good example because that's a category one. But you will have like different areas that you can use. So that's for the image part, that's for the name part, and you can swap both in the code to have a different display or do more complex stuff. And this will be done as an override in your template. So when you update eCashup, you don't lose your changes. And so it's easy to update eCashup and not stay behind and don't get the new features if you need or the fixes that you need. So then you can, I'll go more in depth into the options. So here, for example, you see all the countries and states that exist on the world, and you can create new ones, disable some of them. Like if you don't want to ship outside Europe, you can deactivate the one you don't use. For example, you don't want to ship to Afghanistan, so you just disable it, and the users won't be able to set an address with that country. You can select payment methods. So we have more than 100 payment methods for eCashup. So we integrate with the most common payment gateways which exist. We have a few for the Polish market, I think. I don't remember the name. It's PayU Poland. So we have a plugin for that. We have PayPal, all the big ones, the CardSave, which works all over the world. And so you can create one, and then it will be usable on the checkout, so that the user can then pay with his credit card directly on your website, or maybe on the payment page of the payment gateway. We have shipping methods, so it's the same during the checkout. The user can select the shipping rates. You can configure different shipping rates for different zones, as you can see here. Here I have set some payment methods for Europe and some others which works for all over the world, and with different prices, different weight restrictions or price restrictions. So based on the products that you have in the cart, they will be the shipping method will be filtered to display only the relevant one to the customer. So that's something we have. Taxes, so that's something that got talked about late before. So you, here you, we only have one tax for whole Europe, but you can create more taxes. So you can have one tax for Poland, one tax for France, one tax for. You can have different taxes for different type of customers. So for example, for businesses, you might have a tax, and for individuals, you might have another tax. For example, in Europe, normally you have. I mean, at least in France, that I know, we have to tax everyone in France. And in the rest of Europe, we only tax the business owners and the individuals who don't provide a valid VAT number that a company should get when you register in your country. Maybe it's automatic in Poland, I don't know. In France, it's automatic. We get a VAT number directly when we register a company. And so that way you can have different taxes for different kind of customers. You can handle the currencies here, so you can have the configure the zloty, the way it would display. So here you can see the yen, the Japanese yen, displays like this, while when you use the euro, you will have like this. So you can configure that, the way it displays. You can configure the rates for the price. So when you don't specify a price, so for example, you configure a price only in zloty, and you want that the price in euro is calculated automatically, so that when people use euro to purchase your products, they will get a price which is converted automatically by KikaShop using the rate that you set here. And then you can configure the emails and orders, and you can have, I won't go too much into the details. You can of course manage the orders, the customers. So for example, let's go in the orders. So when at the end of the checkout, when the person click on finish, an order will be created for the user with the products in his order, and you will see it here. And by default, it will be created. And when the payment is done on the payment gateway, like for example in on the PayPal website, PayPal will notify your website, and KikaShop will confirm the order and send a notification email to the person to say that the payment has been received and that the order will be treated later on or whatever you want. So that way you can have, like for example, with PayPal, when someone pays with electronic bank transfer, it can take a few days to process the transfer, and so the order might stay created for a few days until the payment is validated by PayPal, and then the order will be confirmed automatically. You had a question maybe? No, not anymore. Right. Okay. So regarding the marketing, first the marketing and SEO are two ways how you can increase your sales on your website. So we have several tools in KikaShop to do that. So here you can see the affiliate system, which can help you bring traffic from other websites to your website, and so you reward your partners for the affiliates that sales that they bring to you. You can, so that's one piece for the marketing, but we also have discounts, so you can create discounts only for some products, for some categories, or you can create also coupons. So the coupons will be a code that the user has to enter on the checkout, and he will get a discount for that. And you can put rules for the coupons. So for example here, I'm gonna show you rapidly. You can set coupons for 10%. So he will get a 10% discount if he enters the code test coupon during the checkout. And you can set restrictions. So for example, that the coupon is valid only for one user and not several times. You can limit it to products, categories, extra, many options. I won't discuss that too much. If you have questions on the options that you find on all the screens of KikaShop, you can click on the help button there, and the help will help page of that page will display with the explanation of each option that you can find. And so that's in English by default, but you can change here the language. So unfortunately, we only do the documentation in English. So if you need it in another language, it will be translated automatically by Google Translate. So if you do it in Polish, you'll see it's going to be funny because sometimes it's not really accurate. But so I can't read, but maybe you can. Besides that, regarding SEO, so I show you the options for the canonical URLs, the alias, the metadata. We also have integrations with the with XMAP, so that you can have a sitemap with links to your products on your website that will increase your visibility on Google. We also have Microdata, a plugin for Microdata, so that will add special tags on your product pages, so that the Google will find more easily the information on the pages, and that will be able to have a better rendering of your links on the search results of Google. We also have integrations with Google for the Google Shopping website, which allow you to display your products on Google Shopping. So that can also increase your visibility. And we have many more features for marketing and SEO. I won't go too far into it because we just have 9 minutes left. We have integrations with many extensions. We have an integration with AC Mailing, so you can have newsletters. For example, you can have an email sent by AC Mailing automatically. After 2 days, if someone had a cart on your website but didn't transform it into an order, so you can notify them and ask them if he had a problem with his order, so you can help him and maybe don't lose a sale because something got wrong. Or you can ask them after a sale, for example, after the order has been shipped, a few days later you can send an email to ask them to post a comment on your products. So we have a commenting system in InkaShop that you can activate, and so the people will be able to add comments on your products if you want. Did you have a question? No? That's fine.
I have a question.
Yeah, great.
You said that you can sell some MP3 or some video through the HikaShop.
Yes.
So I see there is a lot of options. So have you got an option of preview, for example, of streaming the video, for example, 10 seconds?
What people do usually is that they cut a special video of the big video, or same for the MP3, they cut a small piece, and they use a content player. You have many extensions on Joomla for content players. It could be modules or content plugins that will allow you to add your player on your website in a Joomla article or on the side. And you can use these plugins and modules inside your product description, for example, and have them play the preview on the product page.
Yeah, but it's a lot of the work. But if it's automated,
the thing is, automatically it's kind of complex to do because then you don't necessarily want it at the beginning, and maybe you have a strange format that is not a normal one, or maybe you have different formats. So to do something directly in HikaShop, it would be a really complex task because all the kind of possibilities. So it's easier to just handle the work to the extensions, the third-party extensions, like the players. And I know that maybe some of them have automated systems like that, where you just provide the link of the full video and they will cut it automatically for you. I don't know all the extensions for Joomla, but there's probably one who can do that, I guess.
No, there is no one.
No?
Yeah, I had to do it on myself.
Okay.
That's why I'm asking.
Okay, then that would be a good idea for an extension for Joomla.
okay. But how does it look like when you buy MP3? You get access to your account and you have links, or you just have links on your email?
Both.
Both.
You can activate which one you want. The emails, it's automatic. The link is added in the email, in the confirmation email. And you can also have a download area. Mm. So I didn't show you that, but we in HikaShop, we have a user control panel. So you can have a page where the user will be able to... Oh, we need to log in. let's log in. Where the user will be able to manage his addresses. Nope. Let's go back. Where the user will be able to manage his addresses, his orders, and also access the downloads. So if he has any downloads, he will see them here automatically. So here we have one, for example. And so he can download them here. So that's great when they purchase a lot of files. They get a sum up of everything because they don't have to go in each order or try to find the email. They have everything here. But then you also have the links in the emails and in the order. If you edit the order of that file, you will see also the link to download the file. And of course, the links are protected. It's not a direct link to the file. Mm-hmm. It's a link to HikaShop. And so HikaShop will check that you purchased the product so that you can get the download. Okay. Do you have any question? Because there's just 4 minutes left.
Yes. What about translation of the front end?
So HikaShop is by default translated in more than 40 languages, including Polish. I don't know the quality of the Polish file because I don't speak Polish, but we have one, hopefully. Huh?
Not yet.
Oh, we have.
Yeah. You don't speak Polish yet.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I don't speak Polish yet. That will be tough. I speak French, English, and Japanese, so that's already a lot. So maybe in the future. But yes, we have translations in many languages, and we are compatible with translation tools like Phalang or Jumpfish, so that you can translate the content of HikaShop. So if you can have your products in different languages on your website, and when you change the language, for example, if you put it in Japanese here, everything will display in Japanese, the product name, the everything. So that's a good way to continue. You had a question. Oh, sorry. You had a question too. Okay. Okay. You mean when you remove the menu and the... But that's a Joomla thing, like you create a special menu to a product page and you remove the menus from that menu and that's it. It's not really HikaShop software. You can do that with any e-commerce solution, even not HikaShop software. Yes?
Are there any functions which are not covered by functionality of HikaShop comparing to other Joomla eShop extensions?
Probably, but I wouldn't be able to tell what exactly. We cover almost anything, I guess. Okay. And the thing that are not by default, we usually have integration with other things. Like for example, we have an integration with Alpha User Points so that you can have points and users can gain points for maybe purchasing some products, and then they can use the points to buy some products. Or you can have, for example, each time someone posts a comment on an extension, he will get 2 points, and then he can use these points to purchase some products. Yeah.
It means full functionality.
Yeah, yeah. Well, then if you have some things that are integrations, sometimes the developer, which is not us, will make you purchase the integration. But yeah, almost anything can be done, so...
Does HikaShop work without any problems with Joomla templates?
Yes. So we have a page on our website where you can get templates for HikaShop that are specifically designed to work well with HikaShop. So these ones are the best ones if you want a simple turn on and use templates. But then if you want, that's going to be tough. Can you help me?
Change, if you could change
Yeah, well, that's gonna be English. Great, thank you. Templates here. So you have these templates, and then it works basically with any template normally. Sometimes, like some templates will have might have some incompatibilities with JavaScript libraries or CSS, but usually it can be fixed quite easily with a few changes. But if the template is done correctly, normally there's no issue. So here you can see some of the templates for HikaShop. We have like maybe 20, something like that. I don't know. Are there any other questions? When are we gonna eat, right?
Yes.
Just now then. And so, thank you. One last thing, if you have questions, you can just ask me anytime during the conference. I'll be here and I can answer you. And if you need more information about the HikaShop, the other extensions that we have on anything, just, or if you want to take a picture, maybe.
Yes.
Great. Thank you very much, everyone. Dziękuję.